seen this movie.
I'm sorry, Captain. It's a restricted area. I can't let you pass without clearance.
Okay. Come here. You want to see my clearance? Maybe I'll just leave this here with you.
Let him pass. Let him pass.
Will Smith, Independence Day, a movie about aliens invading Earth. But now the United Nations is getting ready for a contact with aliens from outer space. This is Maslin Offman. She's out of Malaysia. She will be planet Earth's first interstellar diplomat. And Michio Kaku is a theoretical physics professor, also host of the Science Channel series, Sci-Fi Science Physics of the Impossible, which is doing great, by the way. How are you doing, by the way?
Very good.
Nice to see you, Michio. And I don't know, is this a goofy idea? Is this a serious idea? What in the world is the UN doing involved in this?
Well, don't expect flying saucers to land on the White House lawn anytime soon, announcing, take me to your leader. It sounds like a goofball idea, but here's the rationale. Sometime later this year, maybe early next year, astronomers will announce that we have discovered Earth-like twins in outer space. And when we gaze out the night sky, somebody may be gazing back at us. But it's not going to be a two-way conversation. It's not like E.T. phone home. It's going to be a one-way conversation, eavesdropping on aliens from outer space, perhaps.
So even if we were able to send a signal, how would we communicate?
That's exactly right. If you have a message in a bottle in the ocean, you can't communicate back to the people sending the message in a bottle, right?
Which makes it seem all kind of strange and goofy. I can understand if you came up with the idea. I can understand if NASA came up with the idea. But what about the United Nations?
I think they want to stake a claim, because right now there are no protocols. There's no way to address an alien ambassador. There's no way to set up how trade would be, what communications and information would be exchanged. So I think they want to like put a stake in the ground and say, we claim this in the name of the United Nations.
Now, I know there are others who believe in life in outer space, and they believe perhaps they've even touched down here on planet Earth already.
Mm-hmm.
But the point that you make about the satellites in the coming year, the Kepler and the Corot satellite?
Yeah, the Corot satellite.
They're
French
looking
satellite.
Deep into space, right?
That's right.
They might be able to find signs of life.
That's right.
But the signs of life would be like, they'd be microbes, right?
Probably.
Michio's walking around up there.
No. So far we have found 500 giant planets in outer space, but none of them are Earth-like. And that's where the Kepler, a U.S. satellite, and Corot, a French satellite, are the wild card. Sometime later this year or next year, we expect them to announce. Astronomers will announce that we found it. The Holy Grail, an Earth-like twin in outer space. But that doesn't mean that doesn't mean they have Fox News. That doesn't mean they have TV, radio.
Or the Science Channel, right? Now, do you know Maslin Offman, the woman out of Malaysia? Have you heard
of
her before?
No, never. It's the United Nations Office of Outer Space Affairs. It's a very obscure agency of the UN.
Right? Very obscure, I would say. Well, we've tried this before. Was it 1977? We sent a message to outer space and
on the Pioneer, the Voyager.
That got us nowhere, did it?
And first, I think it's premature for us to announce our presence in outer space until we know their intentions, right? I mean, they may view us as lunch, in which case maybe it's a good idea to keep ourselves a little bit obscure.
And as someone said, if they're looking for intelligent life, they don't want to start the United Nations. That was what they said anyway. Michio, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see how the department does, and who knows, maybe they'll give us an interview.
Mm-hmm.
And so when that alien touches down and watches your program, by gosh, you can give him the signal.
Okay.
Thank you, Michio.